It's got a real mahogany nose.
We're back.
We are back.
We are getting ready to head down to Tallahassee, Florida, take on the Florida State Seminoles in their house. It's hot as hell there.
Yeah, capital of Florida.
I mean, in the summertime, it's almost unbearable.
How well do you know your 50 states?
Yeah, I travel to Florida quite a bit.
Tallahassee is the capital.
It is, correct.
So this is a big game.
Capital of Washington State?
Washington City?
Wrong. Olympia. But Washington City is accepted in some countries.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Let's get to those dadgum highlights.
Exciting game. He lost his hat.
But we stole some cookies in Tallahassee.
We did steal some cookies. I like cupcakes, but cookies, they're fine as well.
Delicious red velvet cookies.
With cream cheese icing. You can't go wrong. Good Lord.
Wow.
Yeah. Woody time.
Woody time. With the win.
Wow. We're going to go co-Woody this game.
Co-Woody.
Because I think it's needed. Because I'm going to tell you why. Once again, somebody played consistent basketball throughout the whole game.
Big shots in the first half.
Big shots in the second half. Huge steal. Mr. Daniel Green. You know what? It's a co-Woody because it was a tie game.
But who broke that tie?
Ty Lawson. Fantastic effort.
Oh, by the way, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ty.
And for you and Mr. Green, since you guys brought the funk, we're going to give you some funk right back.
Oh, yeah.
Cool and the Gang's greatest hits.
Doesn't get funkier than that.
It's a celebration.
If this greatest hit CD does not make you want to make buckets and win games, I don't know what will. Let's not forget about track number 13. Take it to the top. That's where we're going, boys. At the end of last week's episode, we gave you what the industry likes to call a teaser.
We certainly did. And it had to do with a past Carolina matchup against Florida State where Sam Cassell referred to the Smith Center fans as a wine and cheese crowd.
And you know what? A lot of people took offense to that.
I was a bit offended at first, but then I thought to myself, man, I love cheese, dairy, it's healthy. And then, vino. Nothing better than a little wine.
If you don't like wine or cheese, not only are you not from this country, you're not from this planet.
So you're an alien.
But bringing it back, Sam Cassell, also known as
the alien. Yeah. Egghead himself. He had a few comments. That's fine. You know, we'd like to take you into the Real Heels kitchen and tell you a little bit about wine and cheese.
Yeah. Not only are we here to set the record straight that wine is awesome, as is cheese, today you're in luck. We are going to give you some wine and cheese pairings for your favorite Carolina basketball player.
We're going to go to the Real Heels kitchen right now and explore a little wine and cheese.
Come with us.
As you can see, we poured some wine and we've cut some cheese.
Plenty for all of you.
So let's dig right into these pairings. Maybe you're a fan of Tyler Hansbrough.
Right here.
Mm-hmm. No, I am. Then you probably enjoy a nice, spicy pepper jack.
Mm.
He's a fiery kind of guy.
Pair that with a hearty Bordeaux.
Bordeaux.
Maybe you're a fan of the G&G boys, Green and Ginyard. Now, if you are, the pairing that you need is, first of all, a nice Grigio. Mm-hmm. And going with the G&G theme,
a sweet Gouda.
Gouda.
The Dutch have been making this for hundreds of years.
They do not play around when it comes to cheese.
No, they do not. Maybe that's not your speed. Maybe you're a fan of our favorite sixth man, Bobby Frasor.
Number 4.
You're going to enjoy a nice Chardonnay.
And if you want some cheese with that, Blue Island. What else? Blue cheese.
Blue cheese.
It's really strange.
From the West Coast, maybe a fan of Deon? Don't worry. You guys are famous for your wines. We have a great one picked out, but first, provolone. Delicious. Simple, but classy.
Napa Valley, where they really know their wine. You don't want to pair that cheap with a nice Cabernet.
Cabernet.
Maybe you got that special lady friend coming over. Why don't you slide this one out, pair it with that provolone.
It's a good night.
It's business time. Maybe a fan of the smooth operator, Wayne Ellington, with a nice Riesling. Mm. Something sweet to the palate.
That is sweet. And to pair your sweet wine, how about some creamy Havarti?
Mm-hmm.
And we know these are tough times economically. If you're in a credit crunch, it's always good to go for some Philly cream cheese. You know Wayne will appreciate that.
Wayne Ellington.
Maybe you like a floor leader, a general. You're going to want somebody who's sharp, like Ty Lawson. Which is why we're going to pair Ty with a sharp cheddar.
And let's not forget about the general of red wines, Shiraz.
Shiraz.
Maybe some of you are just fans of Jed Drake.
Jed's here to give you keys to the game for that team down the road that we're pretty sure enjoys Cheese Whiz and Boone's Farm. Mm. Take it to the studio, Jed's keys to the game.
Well, as you can see, I'm here in the Real Hills studio, and we're ready to take a little visit down to our favorite party in the pasture. So I'm going to give you my keys to the game.
Keys to the game.
Is that necessary? That's the keys to the game.
Sorry.
Number one. We need some more offensive production for my guys down low, not named Psycho T. Number two, we're going to have to guard the three. And key number three, as always, little Tyler Hansbrough.
Three!